everybody. How's it going? I'm doing this quite a bit later than I wanted to. Wednesdays are weird here because we usually have co-op. Today we didn't, but I had other things I had to run and do, so messed up my time. I'm trying to do this Monday, Wednesday, and Friday in the morning, but it is actually 3 o'clock, so didn't do a very good job of that. So on Monday we talked about showing a little love to your kids. Valentine's week, and today I want to talk a little bit about to your spouse or significant other, and of course that's always a good way to do that is with food. And so a great way to I heard my husband talking and I got totally off track. See, he's here too, so anyway, okay, food. So we subscribe to this this way of eating called Nourishing Traditions, and we don't eat every meal that way, but we try and do as much as possible. So Nourishing Traditions is a, hi Edie, how are you? Is a great way to get a very well-rounded diet, and it's really all about the best way to get that nutrition into your body. And you do things like you ferment things, you sprout things, you really pay attention to how that nutrition enters your body. And I'll show you, there's a cookbook, and I'll of course post this later. There is a cookbook that gives you lots of great ideas, but it's all about the best, healthiest, most nutritionally available food. And so it's not some crazy fad diet or anything like that. It's very traditional. And so it's based on the work of Weston A. Price. He was a dentist that went around and surveyed all of these ancient, older civilizations, and were they healthy? How long did they live? What did their teeth look like? All that stuff. And so it's also sort of been culled down into this nursery tradition. So that's what we do. So I want to explain what that's about. So let me give you a little example. So if you eat certain foods are kind of built to protect themselves. And a really simple version of this is oatmeal. So the oats in oatmeal are actually created to protect themselves. They have a harder coating on the outside so that when animals eat them, they will poop them out so that more things grow. So what we need to do is start to break down that coating so that our body can get more of the nutrients in it, because oatmeal is very good for you, but it's really a whole lot better if you break down the outer coating. So how you do that is with a tiny bit of fermentation. Now the nice thing about oatmeal is you can do it just overnight. So what we do is we take a cup of oatmeal, take a cup of water, and then you can put plain yogurt, or you can put apple cider vinegar, anything that's got some acidity to it, lemon juice. Lemon juice has a stronger flavor, and so we don't do that. But the other two things, the yogurt or the apple cider vinegar, we usually do apple cider vinegar just because it doesn't go bad like yogurt does as much. So, and you put all that together, lightly cover it, you know, so some air can get out, and let it sit overnight for like 12 hours. And so if you do it one night, or put it on your counter at night, and yeah, you leave it out. And my cat is now asking me for a treat. Leave it overnight, and then you cook the oatmeal in the morning. You can't really taste the apple cider vinegar. It maybe has a teeny tiny bit of an acidic flavor, but you really can't taste it. And especially once you get the good stuff like heavy cream, or if you want to put some maple syrup, use the real maple syrup. If you want to put that stuff in there too, then it completely obliterates that teeny tiny bit of acidy taste. You can do this also, I've done soaked beans before, because the outer coating on beans is harder to digest, and I'm telling you what, they were the best beans I've ever made. In fact, I ought to do some more, because it's cold today, and it would be really good. You can do this with your flour when you cook get a whole lot more of ideas. But it's really good. And the thing is, you really want your gut to be healthy. Again, if you guys have heard me say anything at all, it's all about your gut. So the eating those kinds of foods will help your gut to stay healthy. And the other thing that I always recommend is a probiotic. If you have any kind of gut issues at all, I would start there. I would also make your diet much more bland to begin with, to let your gut heal a little bit, and don't eat any of the allergens that you think you possibly could have. I'm not great at that all the time. It's not easy. Believe me, I get it. It's not easy. But if you do a probiotic, it will help. It will increase your chances of healing your gut too. So a probiotic is basically good bacteria. Your gut is tied to everything. It affects your physicality. It affects your immunity. It affects all that stuff. So what we need to try and do is help our gut with the good bacteria as much as we possibly can. So if you are on an antibiotic, wait until you're done with the antibiotic because it'll just counteract each other if you're still taking it. So wait until the second you're done and take them all. But the second you're done, start taking probiotics. Because that will allow your gut to get that good bacteria back. Because when you're taking antibiotics, it cleans everything out, good or bad. So you need to get those good ones back in. The probiotic that I recommend is Life 9, again, because of transparency. I'm all about, let's see everything from start to finish. That's why, shopping at farmers markets is great, because you can meet the farmer and all that stuff. But you need to be able to see where things come from, all the way from going into the ground to the bottle. You really need to be able to, if you cannot ask the company where it comes from and they give you a real answer, then don't buy that brand. I'm serious about that. The company Life 9 is made by, well, you can go plant plants at the farm if you want. It's really cool. So that's what you need to do. Okay, so wrapping it up. Nourishing Traditions, take a look at it. They do have a website that's got a lot of great information. You can get on the Weston A. Price Foundation website, and I will post those as well. A lot of good information there too. And then Life 9, probiotic. So do yourself a favor and start with your gut, and then hopefully things will fall into place after that. So I'll leave it there, and I will see you on hopefully Friday morning, not 3:15 in the afternoon again. So thanks for watching.